You introduce.
And then you will say whatever it is.
Let me get my papers out.
You need papers?
Yeah, I don't remember what I wrote.
Okay. So tell me what you wrote.
Yeah, give me a ticket. So.
I'd like to introduce Kalim Aziz. Kalim and I go way back. The first time we met was in 1988.
Jesus, 30 years. Fuck me.
Yeah, allow that to percolate for a second. Even at that point, Kalim was very interested in a lot of topics that I knew nothing about. Economics, finance, accounting, analysis, business. And that remains true till today. So Kalim is visiting from the UK, and we're very fortunate to have a session with him. So please listen well. Whatever questions you have, is it okay if they ask during the session?
Anytime, anywhere, any place, and anything. I mean anything. You want to talk about? You want to talk about waterfalls? We'll talk about waterfalls. You want to talk about geoscience? You want to talk about geoscience?
Stop at around 11 p.m. So
The questions. I mean, you want to ask any questions? I'm fine with it.
So Kalim is the lead at Care Advisory, which is a company that he owns and runs. He's an analyst who's appeared on global news programs. His views are sought by multinationals and CEOs when they're looking at acquisitions. Like I said, we're very lucky to have.
Thank you very much
for coming, Kalim. Over to you.
Thank you very much. Very, very briefly about myself, I started reading at the age of, I think, about 11. That's what the first time I got an encyclopedia for myself as a birthday present. So since then, I have never looked back. From a professional perspective, I analyze things, businesses, projects, countries, economies, societies, faiths, religions, astrophysics, geophysics, chemistry, maths. Maths is quite interesting as well. Philosophy, psychology, child behavior, human behavior, social behavior. The only area which I stay away from is what my friend's area of focus is, which is marketing. I don't do that. My motto, if one wants to have one, is nullus anvarba. Don't take anybody's word for it. Use your own brains. And that has always been the case. In whatever way, form, or manner, I always try to seek the truth, which makes me feel comfortable in what it is. And that's all that matters to me. And this process through which I have earned a living as a stockbroker, I've earned a living as head of research, managing a team of 70 people, training and teaching them how to go about analyzing businesses, valuing them and all that. On top of that, I have managed money for a lot of rich people as well as asset manager, and the same process appears. I need to know what I'm looking at. I need to seek the truth, and on that basis, I actually do my job. So I think I'm a reasonably fast reader. I think I read more than the average. I would say that's easy, right? So, and I try to speak to the authors that have written the books. And that's all that matters to me. That's all about me, that's what I do. I advise people, I advise companies, I advise businesses. At the moment, I am on a quest to understand Pakistan. I'm trying to figure out what will make it work as a country. So that's my latest venture, I guess. And so far I've done about 2,600 or 2,700 pages of reading. I made about 600 pages of notes. That has taken me about less than 3 months. So we'll see. That's the introduction. Is that, Umar, that's okay? Yeah? So shall we go to slide one? How do I go to slide one? Somebody does that. Yeah, wee.
Every time you put your background, it goes forward.
कैसे हुआ ये? Can somebody do this? I hate technology. I use pen and paper. I kid you not. So, first and foremost, you need to understand that this is my view of how I would do it. It's not in a book. It's not prescriptive. It's just an idea, a perspective, a way one would do something. So, in this, I want to cover today is, what does strategy means to me? It may be different than a book definition or whatever you have been taught or whatever you want to think about. That's what it means to me. What areas would I consider within the construct of business strategy? How can I break this down into sub-segments or sub-strategies? Give you an idea of some things that you need to keep on the back of your mind to make sure that you don't lead yourself astray. I'll give you my summary thoughts of what type of world we are living in today and how would that affect the way you make views. Give you some examples to get your juices flowing. A thinking example is something which a friend of mine and Umar's Aisha asked me, why don't you do some research on this? So it's a snapshot of how I started to think about it, to understand whether I'm able to do this or not. That's that. And the last one is how I view the world. And that's about it, I guess. So let's start with what it means to me. As I mentioned to you earlier, I'm not good at marketing. I really hate that. Because marketing, I believe, is something which makes people, rational people, make irrational decisions all the time. That's what marketing is about. And that's not me who's saying it, that's Noam Chomsky saying that. And he's a credible guy, and he's a very, very intelligent guy. It makes you do things which you really don't want to do at prices which are stupid and don't make any sense. That's what marketing is about, as far as I'm concerned. Don't say that to Umar, but that's what his job is. So, it's just a fancy word. Strategy, it's a military fancy word. It simply, to me, means how do I go about getting something done? Whatever that is, it doesn't matter what it is. It's applicable in wide number of activities. Economic strategy, Ministry of Finance is supposed to do that, never does it, nowhere in the world. Military strategy, yeah. How not to lose your shirt, and if you do, how to pretend that it was not your fault. Social, this is how you organize a society. There is always has to be a strategy and a different model. Political strategy, how to win an election. Trump did it fantastically well. I mean, I think for bang for a buck, I don't think anybody in the history of America has done better than him, without a shadow of doubt. In terms of campaign management, in terms of spending money to get elected. Personal strategy, what do you want to do with your life and how do you want to go about doing that with your life? Business, that's what we're talking about. Legal strategy. Sometimes when you are at the losing end of a case, you have to decide how you lose the least. That's also a strategy. Scientific, you have strategies to figure out how to find out about things. Research obviously requires a certain plan or a strategy. Then we are, because we are trying to focus on business, I guess, that's the topic today. I think you can read it, right? Yeah. A business is nothing more than a collection of organized, however efficient or inefficient, set of activities aimed to solve a problem by delivering goods and or services that it has identified in a marketplace. Hopefully in a manner that is beneficial for the business. That's what it is. There's only one motive for a business to exist. That is to make profits. Yeah. That's the only thing that matters for a business, is to make profits. Yeah. Everything else is a fancy drama that we are trying to serve the society, or we are trying to provide benefit for this or do that. We are for the welfare of the system. That's all nonsense. They exist to make profits. Right? This translates into nothing more than a collection of problem-solving exercises. It's like a big puzzle, right? And the strategy aims to deliver solutions to the problems that are faced by business. What do I do? What do I sell? How do I sell? How do I source it? How do I make it? How do I finance it? How do I fund it? How do I man it? How do I resource it? These are all elements of strategy or problem-solving exercises. And we talked about something which is very important, a marketplace, right? To keep that in mind, a business which does not understand a marketplace always fails. Marketplace is a place, or is an area of where a business conducts its activities. It's very important to know that which marketplace a business is working in. Without knowing that, you'll always miss out. Am I bothering you? Am I confusing you? Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm
good.
I ask him that question every class.
Okay. So, when we were talking outside, you have to be able to clearly identify and articulate a problem. 90% of the time, if you know what the right question is, you actually know the answer to that question. If you don't know the right question, you will never know the answer. Or you will never know a plausible answer. An answer which is a possibility of solving a problem. You have to scope a problem properly. Scoping is an exercise where I find the most amount of difficulty in doing something. So, for example, if how do I get this in? Name me any issue that you are concerned of or you want to know about. Just come on, give me a name. Give me a topic, anything. Hello?
Anything? The rise of harassment in
I'm sorry?
Rise of
harassment in a society. Okay. So you have to scope this. What do you mean by harassment? And at what level it becomes a harassment? And at what level is just a normal activity or a normal jibing or jesting? And what size of population you would consider to be in a position of being harassed, right? So for example, a child who is struggling to read or learn maths or read something, yeah? And the parent is saying, no, aapko beta ye karna padega, let me make you sit down and study this for 2 hours, usko do tuition lagwa diye, usko achhe school mein dal diya. Is that harassment? Is the parent harassing a child? Why not? Maybe it's not in the capacity of the child to do it. So that's why I say it's important to know where you draw the line of what is harassment and what is not. Similarly, bude maa baap ho jate hain, theek hai? Bachcho ne apne maa baap ke liye financially to provide kar diya, naukar chaakar rakh diye hain, theek hai? Jab baap maa bolti beta mere paas waqt nahi guzarte, meri baatein nahi sunte, ye nahi karte. And beta bol deta hai ki yaar, I have no time for you, I have to look after my kids and my parents. Is that harassment? It's an emotional harassment, isn't it?
It's different for everybody.
No, you have to define it, what level of harassment you want to attack as a problem to be solved. And this exercise is what is known as scoping. Right? You have to define the parameter under which you want to work. Otherwise, you will lose out because you don't know which part of the problem you are attacking. Right? That's very important. Agar aap police wala aapko harass karta hai, that's a different kind of a problem. Agar ladke ladkiyon ko harass karta hai, that's a different type of a problem. So unless you scope your problem clearly, you will not know how to solve it because it's too wide, too big, too insurmountable for you to even have a look at. It's very important to know how to scope a problem. You need to be able to measure. This is one of the most difficult things in the world to do, is to understand what is the right way to measure something. Any thoughts of what you want to measure? Any questions? Any ideas? What would you want to measure? Ek, let's say a problem hai. Aapki tabiyat kharab ho gayi hai. So what does the doctor do? First thing, what does he do?
Huh?
How do, what does he do? How does he check you? Yeah, ye jo be specific. What does he do? No. What is the specific thing that the doctor do when you say ki meri tabiyat kharab hai? What does he do? What's the first thing that he takes the temperature. That's one thing he measures. Then he takes your blood pressure, second thing. The third thing he does is he takes your pulse. So these are the three things he uses to measure something. What is he trying to do? Temperature se kya malum chalega? Body temperature se kya malum chalta hai? Okay. Body temperature of 98.6 tells you that person's body temperature is elevated. Elevated temperature is defined as fever. So what does it mean to him? What is he trying to measure? Is he trying to measure whether you have fever or not? Is he trying to measure that there is infection in you or not? Because body's response to infection is to raise the temperature. As the body's temperature is raised, it tries to contain the spread of infection. So when he is measuring your body temperature, what he is trying to look for is whether you have infection or not. Right? So when he's doing his blood pressure, he's trying to find out something in addition to find out whether you have infection or not. When he's looking at pulse, he's also trying to see how hard your heart is working to supply the body with nutrients, or whether that is compromised in any way or not. So he's using three different tools, measuring something else, and he uses these measures to find out something, right? So in the same way, when you're trying to implement a strategy, you have to come up with measurement tools which allows you to measure whether the strategy that you are implementing is working or not, or whether you have to change this or not. That's the purpose of measurement. Thermometer se temperature dekhna uska maqsad nahi hai, kuch aur maqsad hai. So you have to understand the difference between a measuring tool and what you are measuring. That has to come at the time of devising a strategy of problem solving. You will not know whether you have solved a problem unless you know how to look for indicators which tells you what the problem is and what have you solved. Kuch kabhi kisi business se taluk pada hai aap logon ka? Have you ever had a contact with any business in your life?
Yes.
Yeah? You interact in the world, right? So, can you name me any business and tell me why it exists? What is the purpose of that business? We know the result is to gain profit. But in order for it to gain profit, it has to do something. There is a reason for its existence.
So like Kalim and Uber.
Okay. The reason of existence of Uber is what? Sorry, I missed that. Convenience of what? I'm still not clear. What was the gap for? What was the cause of the gap? Why was it needed? Why was it necessary?
People were previously using public transport and not everybody
transport.
So we are identifying three or four different elements which was being addressed by Uber or Kareem. Kareem is, by the way, owned by my Sala. I'm not kidding you. Modi Bhai is my Sala, you know, na? He's my wife's cousin. He owns Kareem. Yeah. He's a big, big, big. I know. So let's talk about the elements of Kareem. Yeah? And how it came into being. So the level of income in this society is not so much that everybody can have his own car or transport vehicle, right? That's the first thing. The public transport infrastructure is not sufficient to cater to the needs and the demands of, yeah. The regulatory infrastructure which was put in place, which would create a necessary mechanism through which the private ply for hire businesses like taxis, rickshaws and motor, where you had to have a meter and your meter would run and you would pay according to that, has completely failed. So fourth thing, very important, safety and security has become a very big issue. So we have four different elements. So Modi identified there are four things that are a problem for a society and people have to get from point A to B. And I don't have the money or the resources to buy a million cars and put in place to make it work. So what do I do? He found a solution, and that's why he exists, right? So that's the reason for that business to exist. So we have to think about what are the consequences of this business existence, how does it affect the society, what is the positive and what are the negative. That's a class in itself, right? So let's... The point I was trying to make is you need to understand the reason for this existence. So you need to identify factors which makes it possible for somebody to create a business. Anything you want to share? Come on. No? No, it's okay. It's okay. Okay. It's okay. I'm really interested in what went on. Seriously. No, I just want to know. There was so much, such an important thing for here to say or do.
That's okay.
The first bit is very important. Unless you understand this, you will have no basis which is reasonable enough to analyze a business. Yeah? You will have no basis. Or your basis will be essentially flawed. And that's where it's important. Second line is very clear. I think you guys can read. Any problem that you face, yeah? Big or small, can be broken down into small constituents, smaller problems. When we started to look at material or matter or whatever in the old days, I'm talking about pre-Aristotelian times, they came up with a word which was atomos, which literally means indivisible. So all matter is made of atoms, right? And they called it indivisible. Right? It's not true. Atom can be divided into at least 116 components, right? 116 components. And how does each component work, and the investigation of that is in itself small problems. Because how a material functions, what's the elasticity of a material, what's the absorptive capacity of a material, how we can break it, how we can extend it or extrude it or flex it or bend it or use it, was decided by figuring out what it is made of, what are the atoms or molecules. Then how the atoms and molecules work were made out of how are the subcomponents and the subcomponents and the subcomponents, right? So the idea is every question that you have can have sub-questions or sub-parts to that exercise. And identifying that to a limit which makes sense is an important part of coming through a concept of strategy. Scoping ki baat kabhi kar li thi, so I don't want to repeat that. When you have broken these things down into pieces, small enough, bite size enough for you to swallow and clearly understand, the answers will occur on its own. The answers almost always lies in the question. So if you don't know the answer to something, read, investigate, research. There's a lot of things that you know that you don't know that you know. Yeah? So you dig deep down into yourself, the knowledge that you have, be it a fleeting knowledge of literature, history, whatever. Maths, I love maths. Yeah. Geometry, trigonometry, or Boolean logic, whatever. You will always find some element of knowledge hidden back in the back of your head which you are able to use to come to the answers to the problems that you've raised. Another thing which is not really common, it's an oxymoron, common sense. That's where most of the problems get solved. But the enemy of common sense is emotions. It's the biggest enemy of common sense. Your passion and your emotions come in the way of using common sense. I know most of us, when we were in school, when we were learning things, we were, Assalamu alaikum.
I'm the program head.
Wa alaikum salam.
Assalamu alaikum. I'm sorry I'm late.
Don't worry. You haven't missed much. Sorry, as we have educated ourselves most of the time, we have learned things in silos. Jo literature ki kitab mein aap literature padhte ho, literature ki class mein baithe ho, literature padhte ho. Physics ki class mein aap physics padhte ho, maths ki class mein aap maths padhte ho. History ki class mein aap history padhte ho. Uske alawa pata nahi aap kya padhte ho, lekin whatever you study. MashaAllah. Physics? Chemistry? Geosciences? Hydrology? So, we read everything, we learn everything in certain silos. Kisi zamane mein jab taleem ka shauk hota tha logon ko, ilm ka shauk hota tha, talking about what? 50 BC, 60 BC, 100 AD? Us zamane mein people used to study everything together. So don't keep these silos separate, break them down. Yeah. Whatever you learn in biology can be applied in business. Whatever you have learned in physics, you can apply in business. Whatever you learned in history, you can apply in business. Psychology definitely. Which is ye marketing ka kaam jo hai na, psychology se khelte hai na insaan ki. So you can apply cross discipline. So don't forget that. Use your brain. I think the maximum you can use is about 8%, but that's good enough. That is what got Einstein to do what he did, right? So that would be top. I'm running at about 0.5%, so that's okay. So as long as you're able to do that, you will be able to learn a lot from what you already know. Lateral thinking is what will give you a problem. The world is going into a different direction where it's specialization, right? But the way you learn about things or solve problem is through lateral thinking. I think that's very important for you to know. What could go wrong is very important. Yeah? You have to think about what could go wrong. And if you don't think about what could go wrong, a lot of bad things happen. And they go wrong. Right? So I don't know, do you guys, anyone here history buff? History? Kisi ko shauk hai? तो हिस्ट्री थोड़ी हुई यार सीरियसली एनीबडी नो वन नोबडी केयर्स बोरिंग लॉट यार हम 1965 में चले जाते हैं 1965 पाकिस्तान कार वो अपना जो हमारे जो पहली जंग दूसरी 1940 सो उसमें हुआ ये था कि अयूब खान साहब समझे उनको समझ क्या आती है मुझे नहीं मालूम लेकिन वो समझे कि यार ये इंडिया हैज़ जस्ट हैड अ ह्यूज वॉर इंडो चाइना वॉर इन 1962 एंड दे हैव बीन पैटेड डाउन मैसिवली सो देयर आर्मी इज फीलिंग रिजेक्टेड बिकॉज दे हैव लॉस्ट दिस वॉर एंड दे आर वेरी वीक तो और वो थके हुए भी हैं उनके एम्यूनिशन भी आधे गले ख़त्म हो चुके हैं ये कहानी हो गई है तो हम ऐसा करते हैं चुपचाप कश्मीर में घुस जाते हैं एंड वी ट्राई टू क्रिएट अ वॉर ऑन कश्मीर वो दे डिड नॉट नो वॉज दे लेफ्ट द होल ईस्टर्न बैंक ऑफ पंजाब ओपन उन्होंने ये सोचा ही नहीं था कि यार उनको भी जज्बाती होके वो भी घुस जाएंगे हमारे इलाके में लाहौर से 10 किलोमीटर तक पहुंच गए थे वी लॉस्ट मोर टेरिटरी ट्राइंग टू गेन समथिंग विच वॉज नेवर आवर्स देन द वॉर एंड ताशकंद अग्रीमेंट हुआ और उसके बाद हमने अपनी ज़मीनें वापस ले ली उन्होंने अपनी ज़मीनें वापस दे दी हमको हमने हाथ पैर जोड़ लिए माफ़ी कर दिया मुँह काला कर कर आ गए सो वॉट कुड गो रॉन्ग इज ऑलवेज इम्पोर्टेंट टू नो राइट और उसके बाद ये भी देखना चाहिए हाउ कैन दिस बी एड्रेस्ड हाउ कैन यू लुक एट थिंग्स दैट कुड गो रॉन्ग कुछ चीज़ें मिटिगेट कर सकते हैं ठीक कुछ चीज़ें मिटिगेट आप नहीं कर सकते जैसे अभी मेरे साथ जो हुआ है आते वक्त यहाँ पर सो आई वॉज फ्लाइंग फ्रॉम लंदन वाया दुबई टू कराची तो माई कनेक्शन वॉज 1 hour and 15 minutes gap. What would go wrong? London, I should have known better. From Heathrow, there is one flight every 50 seconds taking off. One flight every 50 seconds landing. ठीक है हवा में खलबली मच जाती है दो तीन मिनट का डिले हो जाता है ना तो ट्रैफिक जैम हो जाता है और ट्रैफिक जैम हो जाता है तो जहाज़ उड़ने में वहाँ से आधा घंटा देर से निकला जहाज़ तो वहाँ से आधा घंटा देर से निकला जहाज़ दुबई में लैंडिंग स्लॉट उसका मिस हो गया और जहाज़ लैंड हुआ अबाउट 10 minutes बिफोर माई सेकेंड फ्लाइट वॉज सपोज टू टेक ऑफ तो उसका तोहफा मुझे ये मिला कि मुझे 7 घंटे दुबई एयरपोर्ट पर बैठ के अंगूठे घुमाने पड़े अपने So, I should know better that don't take a flight out of London which is connecting in the Middle East with 1 hour time difference. If I had planned that better, I would have not spent 22 hours getting from London to Karachi. I would have saved a lot of time. Instead of a 1 hour gap, 2.5 hour gap would have been much better. So, what would go wrong? Always important. Or avoid me too solution. I'm not asking you to reinvent the wheel, but avoid me too solution. अगर सबने me too solution किया तो वो फेल हो जाएगा कि यार ये तो है इसने तो अपनी दुकान जो है इस गली में लगाई है उसके धंधा चल रहा है सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल लेट्स पुट अ पिज्जा हट एट बोट बेसिन एट वर्क सो पिज्जा हट सेल्स पिज्जास इन बोट बेसिन आई वॉन्ट टू सेल पिज्जा लेट मीस ओपन अ शॉप एट बोट बेसिन अगेन And second one, then a third one, then a fourth one, and a fifth one, and a sixth one, and the seventh one, and the eighth one. By the time there are 9 pizza shops in that street, nobody is making money. Because you're trying to copy the same thing. Sorry? 9 pizza streets in a straight street would work?
What if your pizza is different than others?
I'm not saying which one will work. I'm saying most of them will bust out. What you're doing is you saw a success of one guy and you copied it. Two guys may work. Three guys may work temporarily. After the sixth or seventh or eighth or ninth guy, I'm trying to say, trying to find the same solution by copying somebody else. It's just a copy. It's not original. You'll lose out.
You're still making profit.
So actually, the point of this is that, for example, if you look at the biscuit category in Pakistan, started out with 5 or 6 players about 10, 15 years ago, and at this point there are probably more than 20 companies producing identical biscuits just with different packaging. Same price point, same cousin, everything is the same. Sirf naam change hua.
Theek hai.
Sab aise kama.
अच्छा अच्छा सवाल है और उसका जवाब मेरे पास भी बहुत छोटा सा है. When you were looking at the biscuit market, when there was one guy who was supplying it, the market was completely unsaturated, right? So the problem was not, उस पहले बंदे की बेवकूफ़ी थी कि उसने मार्केट कैप्चर नहीं की, right? So you're not copying a strategy. What you're trying to do is you're trying to identify a gap in the market, scoping the demand better, right? So it's not that you're copying, maybe biscuit bana raha hu, maybe biscuit bana raha hu. Isko continue kare ad infinitum, I promise you. Kaafi logon ke pad jayega. Even you know this, right? Ice creams, the first one, the market leader makes a killing. The second one survives with a decent margin. Third one badly makes it. And on before, uske baad sare ka sare baade aate hain. Unless you are a specialist niche, jaise Haagen-Dazs hai, wo kabhi bhi nahi badhega. दुनिया में कुछ भी हो जाए उसको कुछ नहीं होगा. कैडबरी बस हो सकती है, लिंट का भी बस नहीं होगा. दैट इज अ मार्केट नीश. सो लिंट इज नॉट सेलिंग यू चॉकलेट, इज सेलिंग यू समथिंग मोर देन ए चॉकलेट. मार्केटिंग वाले आपको तो समझ आनी चाहिए उसकी. ठीक
है
यार, नहीं आती मुझे. यस अच्छा, व्हेन आई डू से, व्हेन आई अंडरस्टैंड समथिंग, that is very different. My understanding or your understanding may be a different level of questions here. Jab mujhe bolta ho ki mujhe ye pata hai, to that's a slightly different phenomenon. Theek hai na? Sub segments pe aa jaye. To pehla to Umar sahab ka segment hai, marketing. You have to have a marketing strategy to deliver goods and services. If you don't have one, ain't gonna work. It can be as simple as there is a demand for shoes and nobody is selling shoes in this market, and I am the only one who can sell shoes. But even then, you have to have a strategy at what price you want to sell, how you want to distribute it, where you want to distribute it, how do you want to market it, what signs of seasonalities do you want today, what kind of refreshing you want to have in designs and everything. You have to have a strategy. Or jahan crowded market hoti hai, wahan pe complexity of marketing strategy becomes very, very difficult. Theek hai na? Bahut mushkil ho jata hai. Lekin you have to have a clear strategy of how do you address the market and deliver goods and services into that market. Kuch cheezein hoti hai, you use certain signals, I guess. Price speaks a lot if you listen to it properly. You can buy market share by reducing the price, and sometimes you can buy market share by increasing the price. It's a weird thing. The way it gives you signals is very, very difficult. But it talks to the consumer. Don't just take, yaar, hum iska daam itna bada denge aur itna kam kar lenge. It talks to the consumer. You need to understand a clear pricing strategy within that. Delivery और क्वालिटी ऑफ सर्विस भी बहुत जरूरी चीज है. उसकी भी अंडरस्टैंडिंग होनी चाहिए कि आपको कैसे डिलीवर करना है. क्लासिक केस इज यू नो अमेजॉन, राइट? पता नहीं इस मुल्क में चलता है कि नहीं चलता, बट इट्स अ मास्टर क्लास. इट्स एन एब्सोल्यूट मास्टर क्लास. उसने रिटेल की बजा दी है, लिटरली बजा दी है हर जगह पे. दे हैव अ स्ट्रेटजी टू डू दिस. दे आर ट्राइंग आउट नाउअडेज automated delivery in a small Farnborough, small town in the UK, where a drone delivers stuff.
Yes, sir.
It is just unbelievable. Oh, delivery system, post office ka bhi ek kahani achhi hai. Uski bhi last mile or middle mile or supply chain ka silsila hota hai. There is another marketing aspects on that. Ab to mujhe bata do kya baat kar rahe the yaar. तो बंदे किधर जाएंगे? बंदे बढ़ जाएंगे.
हाँ,
what to do. नहीं इनकलाब से भी कोई फायदा नहीं है. वो लोग कम हो जाएंगे ना तो फायदा होगा जो बच जाएंगे उनका शायद. प्रोडक्शन एंड सप्लाई चेन आप मेरे ख्याल से आप पढ़ा चुके होंगे उनको. व्हाट इज द सप्लाई चेन किसी को पता है? ओके सॉरी. सबसे कॉम्प्लेक्स सप्लाई चेन किसकी है कुछ अंदाजा है? इस जो तुम इस्तेमाल बहुत करते हो सबसे कॉम्प्लेक्स सप्लाई चेन किसकी है? आईफोन. जस्ट अनबिलीवेबली कॉम्प्लेक्स सप्लाई चेन और वो ऑन द डॉट इन द नोज ऑन द मनी डिलीवर करते हैं इसको. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. अगर सप्लाई चेन में कुछ गड़बड़ी हो गई उसका जो मदरबोर्ड है फोन का इज मेड बाय ATS. इट्स एन ऑस्ट्रियन कंपनी एंड द कमिटमेंट टू एप्पल टू डिलीवर दैट मदरबोर्ड विच विल नॉट फेल इज मिलियन टू वन. इफ द सप्लाई मिलियन पीसेस ऑफ दैट द टॉलरेंस लेवल ऑफ एक्सेप्टेंस इज वन कैन गो रॉन्ग इन अ मिलियन. So that is how it manages its supply chain. अच्छा दूसरी बात हमारे पंकज साहब हैं पंकज मिश्रा जी वो कहते हैं ह्यूमन रिसोर्सेज के बारे में. ह्यूमन आइडेंटिटी इज ऑलवेज मैनीफोल्ड एंड सेल्फ कॉन्फ्लिक्टिंग इन मैनी वेज. बड़े अच्छे आदमी हैं बड़ा कमाल की किताबें लिखते हैं ये. यू आर ए डॉटर टू समबडी ए सिस्टर टू समबडी अ फ्रेंड टू समवन एंड होपफुली समटाइम इन द फ्यूचर a wife to someone. So you have four or five different personality. I'm not talking about you. But you also have different personalities, right? Different roles.
More than four or five.
Yeah. So every, sometimes it's conflicting. Bibi bolti hai, amma tang kar rahi hai mujhe aur meri baat nahi maan rahi hai aur ye nahi ho raha, wo nahi ho raha. Amma bolti hai ki bahu meri baat nahi maanti. So there are always conflicting roles inside you. Human beings are very conflicted by definition because too many things go around there. You need to understand that carefully and you have to use that in your strategy on human resourcing and manpower resourcing. It's very important to do that. Aur aakhri wala jo hai wo main karta hu financial wala. To ye jo teen char cheeze aapko bataiye marketing production supply chain human resources there has to be a financial strategy to match that. Agar nahi karega to business ka thappa ho jana hai guaranteed. You have wrong structure of financing, wrong price of financing, wrong mechanism of financing. Ye patta baithna hai, things will go wrong. ये हो नहीं सकता कि वट एवर यू से थिंक और डू विल वर्क विल गो रॉन्ग. दैट्स द नेचर ऑफ द बीस्ट. और कहां से नजर आता है इस गोल्स एंड एक्सपेक्टेशंस राइट दैट विल गो रॉन्ग. इफ माई स्ट्रैटेजी इज टू लूज 40 किलोज इन अ ईयर आई गारंटी यू इट विल गो रॉन्ग. दिस इज एन इनकरेक्ट एक्सपेक्टेशन. ये ब्लैक स्वान्स का हैव यू हर्ड ऑफ दैट टर्म ब्लैक स्वान्स? क्या मतलब है? व्हाट डज इट मीन? इट्स अनफोर्सिएबल चेंज विच कैन रॉक. सो जो फोर्सिएबल है that you can try to plan or understand or mitigate or do whatever. Black swans, there's nothing you can do. You can't even see it coming because it's a black swan, right? Regulatory changes bhi bada phatta dal deti hain, masle ho jate hain. Pakistan duniya bhar mein hote hain. Pakistan mein regulatory changes nahi hote, aisa aur ek hi duniya chalti hai na. No, regulatory changes sometimes create a huge mess as well. Resource handicaps, misplanning can create a problem as well. यार हमने तो उसको ऑफर लेटर दिया था, वो तुम्हारे पास काम करने वाला था, उसने छह काम करके फिर भाग गया. एंड ही इज द टेक्निकल डिजाइनर ऑफ अ प्रोडक्ट, तो देयर इज नथिंग यू कैन डू. फैक्ट्री में हड़ताल हो गई. अच्छा, कभी कभी आप बात नहीं सुनते, जो कि आदत है. कान अल्लाह ने दो दिए, जबान ने एक दिए, लेकिन सुनते कम है लोग. यू हैव टू लिसन टू द वॉइसेस, एंड द बिगेस्ट स्पीकर टू द वॉइसेस ऑफ अ बिजनेस इज द मार्केट. उसकी बात नहीं सुनोगे तो बढ़िया होगे. टेक्नोलॉजी ये भी फटा बिठाती है, ठीक है जी, इसका बड़ा एग्जाम्पल दूंगा बाद में. और बैड लक, जिसको हम क्या कहते हैं, शिट हैपेंस. थैंक गॉड फॉर दैट. अच्छा, ये थोड़ी सी छोटी सी विंडो है, मेरी विंडो है, थ्रू अबाउट द वर्ल्ड हाउ आई एम सीइंग इट. किसी जमाने में हम लोग सिर्फ ह्यूमन बींग्स वर हंटर गैदरर्स, राइट? दे वर हंटर गैदरर्स एंड देर लिव्ड इन, दे हैड अ वेरी नोमैडिक लाइफस्टाइल. 14,000-15,000 साल पुरानी बात है. एंड सम ओवर द अदर वी फाउंड अ वे टू नॉट मूव इन सर्च ऑफ फूड, एंड दैट्स व्हेन एग्रीकल्चर केम इनटू बीइंग एंड वी बिकेम अग्रेरियन सोसाइटीज. अग्रेरियन सोसाइटीज व्हेन दे स्टार्टेड एम्प्लॉयड अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल टू डिलीवर अ फ्यू थिंग्स. तभी हम बहुत सारी सोसाइटीज में जाके देखते हैं, या हिस्ट्री में आप जाके देखो, इफ यू गो बैक इन टाइम यू विल फाइंड दैट अ लार्ज पॉपुलेशन, परसेंटेज ऑफ पॉपुलेशन वाज एम्प्लॉयड इन एग्रीकल्चर. एज द एग्रेरियन सोसाइटी अडॉप्टेड टेक्नोलॉजी, द नंबर ऑफ पीपल एम्प्लॉयड बाय इन द एग्रीकल्चर सेक्टर श्रंक मैसिवली. तो वो हुआ इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन के साथ. तो इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन डेसिमेटेड द जॉब्स which exists for the agrarian society. And then it also decimated the jobs for artisans. Aapke paas kumbhar hota tha, badai hota tha, lohar hota tha. I mean, there was a time, I'll give you an example. Pakistan ki industry, textile, right? Shuttle wali lume hoti thi, haath se kapda banta tha, wo banda thak, thak, thak. So every shuttle had one person working on it, and because there were three ships, so there were three people employed on a single shuttle. Uske baad automatic loom, semi-automatic loom aa gaye, so one person per four shuttles or four looms. And then there was water jet, then air jet. Ab Switzerland mein Sulzer Ruti ka naam to shayad suna hoga, badi company hai, ab bahut kam kapda banati hai, wo specialist banati hai. There are 148 looms running in a factory, one man running it. ठीक है, इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन का कमाल है. लेकिन इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन का एक और फायदा भी हुआ है कि हाउ डू आई एक्सप्लेन दिस, द आइडिया इज टू फ्री टाइम. या द कॉन्सेप्ट इज टू फ्री टाइम. एक आदमी इफ यू स्पेंड 70% ऑफ योर टाइम टू प्रोड्यूस material to consume, you have very little time left to do something else, right? And your wage and the price at which that material is produced is very high. If it takes 10% of your time, the cost of producing goes down, so more people have access to it. That's the benefit of the industrial revolution. So ek tarah se usne employment ko change kiya, reduce kiya requirement ko, lekin usne affordability bhi badha di. That also created another series of employment. अब जो हम बैठे हैं, वी आर सिटिंग प्रोबेबली इन द अर्ली स्टेजेस ऑफ डिजिटल रेवोल्यूशन. सो फ्रॉम एग्रीगेरियन टू इंडस्ट्रियल टू डिजिटल्स, और ये तबाही है. दिस इज अ कंप्लीट डेसिमेशन of labor requirements. So jaise aapne Uber ki baat ki, thought about Uber. In the UK, there are official black cabs, right? And there were mini cabs. Black cabs you can hail on the road, mini cabs you can't. Mini cabs were small offices somewhere where you would call in, and the guy on the phone will take your name and number and blah, 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 quote you a price, which was cheaper than the black cab, and dispatch you a car. So, you have to take it from your house or take it from the hotel. Uber came. So, the thousands of people who were dispatching the work, they button and you have to work. There are 48 people who work in the industry, in the whole country. So, the number of jobs that can be destroyed by technology is humongous. Not only that, and the nature of job is also very important. And this is going, it's horrifying. So, ji. Good question, answer. It's the extent that we are talking about, and it's the extent of adaptability of human beings that we are talking about. Okay? So let's imagine your father is 42, 44 years old, right? He's been working in a bank as an account manager, right? And there are lots of fathers who are working in a bank and account manager, that goes. So those account managers who are out of jobs, do you think they will be able to retrain themselves into an IT gizmo thing?
Is that technical
term, IT gizmo? You gizmo, buttons. Press the button, you do this, press the button, you do that. Computer answers all the things. I have not been into a bank branch for the last 7 years. खुलने गया था अकाउंट बस उसके बाद मैं बैंक में गया ही नहीं हूँ और मुझे पता भी नहीं है कि मेरा बैंक मैनेजर कौन है ब्रांच कौन है क्या है किस तरह से सारा मशीन पे हो जाता है वो भी बीबी कर देती है कि भाई पैसे भेजने हैं पैसे लाना है ये करना है वो करना है आई हैव नॉट विजिटेड माई अकाउंटेंट फॉर माई फर्म वंस आई डोंट नो इवन हिज नेम और अ फेस और व्हाट इट लुक्स लाइक और व्हाट इट डज ठीक है मुझे मालूम ही नहीं है क्या है 1999 अ मंथ एंड माई अकाउंट्स आर डन आई हैव नॉट विजिटेड माई टैक्स अकाउंटेंट I don't even know what his name is or who it is. So that's a huge, huge chunk. You can replace the whole team of accountants for a small business by buying an app for $19.99 a month. Whoa, that can't be, those people can't be retrained. It's going to happen. And the substitution effect is something which you are missing out on. So let's talk about people who are going to get a law degree in Europe or the US or wherever, right? So, वो 6 साल अपनी पढ़ाई में लगाएंगे 6 साल के बाद जो वो निकलेगा वो जूनियर लॉयर ठीक है उससे ज्यादा तेज a machine will be able to do. It will be able to find out laws, write contracts, do this, that, and the other for you at the drop of a button. So, that guy will not have the chance to practice. Law as we know it. Super senior or senior lawyers ki zarurat zarur padegi. Lekin senior lawyers banne ke liye wo junior ko experience chahiye hoga na. Wohi nahi milega. That is not going to be available and that is the biggest problem, the challenge we are facing from now on for the next 50 years. Ye jo mujhe marketing aati hai, main advertising aur branding kar sakta hoon ya मैं अकाउंटिंग कर सकता हूँ या मुझे लॉ आता है और मैं कॉन्ट्रैक्ट लिख सकता हूँ ये चल भाई 19 pounds 99 pence एंड आई हैव अ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट फॉर अ रेंटल अग्रीमेंट इंस्टेड ऑफ 400 पाउंड व्हिच आई यूज्ड टू पे टू अ लॉयर टू गेट अ रेंटल अग्रीमेंट तो वो जो है और दिस गाइस हु वर राइटिंग दिस रेंटल अग्रीमेंट्स वंस दे न्यू हाउ टू राइट अ रेंटल अग्रीमेंट्स दे वर यूज्ड टू लर्न टू डू लेबर कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स एंड एन एम्प्लॉयमेंट कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स एंड अ बिजनेस कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स एंड दोस थिंग्स They will not have the chance to do the experience. डायग्नोस्टिक में चले जाए, मेडिकल डायग्नोस्टिक में चले जाए, नवा बच्चा है, नया डॉक्टर बना है, डॉक्टर साहब डायग्नोस्टिक के लिए उसको जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी, ही विल नॉट हैव स्पेस टू लर्न टू ट्रीट ह्यूमन बींग्स व्हेन दे हैव कॉम्प्लेक्स डिजीजेस बिकॉज ही विल नॉट हैव द एक्सपीरियंस टू डू द सिंपल वंस, सिंपल वंस विल बी डन बाय द मशीन्स एंड दैट इज द किलर, दैट इज द किलर। ये चीजें जो है ना आपकी जो कॉमन धंधे हैं जो बिजनेसेस हैं इट्स अ बॉम्बशेल, यू हैव टू नो दिस इट्स अ बॉम्बशेल। सो द वे द बिजनेस इज कंडक्टेड, द वे व्हाट बिजनेस इज विल चेंज। सो ये इसी बात को थोड़ा एग्जांपल से करते थे, हाउ हाउ आई डूइंग ऑन टाइम, नहीं मेरे पास टाइम है। सो जो मार्केट प्रोडक्ट का सिंपल एग्जांपल है, द जीनियस ऑफ स्टीव जॉब्स, यू नो दैट राइट, व्हाट वाज इट, व्हाट वाज द जीनियस ऑफ स्टीव जॉब्स व्हेन ही लॉन्च्ड द आईफोन, व्हाट वाज हिज जीनियस, ही फिगर्ड आउट अ नीड व्हिच यू डिडंट नो दैट यू हैड अ नीड, right, that was his genius, he knew ki yaar ye phone jo hai is a connectivity device aur purane tarike ke jo phone baithe hue usme button lage hue hain 12 button hai and you are limited by the button and a tiny screen and there was so much so little you can do, aur bahut kamal kar diya tha kisi ne camera upar se laga diya aur ye chota sa buddh tha to ye hatane ke liye bade aaram se usne kaha let me do something, I'll make the whole bloody screen as a keyboard and a keypad and a touch screen and I will use the screen to display and I will use the screen to do the bed and a smartphone one is invented. Hamare Nokia bhai sahab jo the, a mobile phone company which had 35% market share in the world, didn't catch on, died, wo puchta nahi hai usko, that was his genius, he found out a product for which people who wanted to buy didn't even know existed a need for that, that's a killer, it killed Nokia, it killed BlackBerry because the security of iOS device was so much better that BlackBerry ka USP ye tha na ki hamare jo server hai wo bahut secure hai, messenger hamara sabse better hai, pad gaya. That thing can happen with the products or services that you are looking at as a business strategy. Oh, Me Too ka jo silsila hai, that's another one on financial side. Ye industry wide baat hai, thodi si business ki nahi hai. So lending was going on in the US market specifically for mortgage products, so there was a certain demand and supply for mortgages, right, the houses people want to buy or whatever income levels and all that. When the interest rate went down, so when it was pushed down in the market, so banks ke paas liquidity hoti thi, they couldn't earn much, so they wanted to promote, create additional demand by selling mortgages. So they loosened their standards a little bit. Underwriting standards ko niche lekar aaye taki lada log qualify kar sake, they started to sell. And then they ran out of money, liquidity. Unne kaha hum liquidity kaise generate kare, hamara to maal bik raha hai, humko aur maal chahiye. Sabun to hai nahi ki factory laga do, paisa hai. Factory lagane se to banta nahi hai, chhap bhi nahi sakte. So what they decided to do was they decided to introduce a financial instrument known as mortgage backed securities. To usne mortgage ke bucket ko ek dabbe mein dala. This is the security against which these people of pieces of paper which are known as bonds, they will be able to get that done. So he sold the bonds, got the money, sell more mortgages. Ek bande ne kiya, to bola ki yaar JP Morgan ne kiya to main bhi karunga. Second one came in, the third one came in, the fourth one came in, the fifth one came in, the sixth one came in. Every bloody bank has sold mortgages, mortgage backed securities. अब तो मॉर्गेज बैक सिक्योरिटीज की भी कहानी खत्म हो गई, तो देन दे क्रिएटेड सुपर मॉर्गेज बैक सिक्योरिटीज व्हिच वाज नॉट नथिंग मोर देन द कलेक्शन ऑफ दीज बॉन्ड्स ऑफ मॉर्गेज बैक सिक्योरिटीज एंड अनदर वन एंड अनदर वन एंड अनदर वन, व्हेन एवरीबॉडी कॉपीड, बूम, अपना मुल्क की तो बर्बादी की, पूरी दुनिया को लूप के लेके चला गया, दैट्स हाउ बैड दैट क्राइसिस वाज। टेक्नोलॉजी में आप देखें तो किसी जमाने में आप फिल्म डेवलप करते थे, अब कोई फिल्म डेवलपर यहाँ पर रहा नहीं है यार, नेगेटिव फिल्म से डेवलप नहीं होती, वो हमारे जो जमाल साहब हैं वो खुद ही घर पर डेवलप करते हैं, टाइप पोलरॉइड नजर ही नहीं आता, कहानी ही नहीं है. दैट्स अ चेंज ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी. कुछ बिजनेस में चेंज होता है, कुछ बिजनेस में चेंज नहीं होता. तो नोइंग विद बिजनेस चेंजेस एंड नॉट इज ऑल्सो इम्पोर्टेंट. लॉजिस्टिक्स की बड़ी कहानी है यार. जो दुनिया में जो सिलसिला हुआ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग मूव में हुआ, द वेस्ट और द डेवलप्ड वर्ल्ड हैज मूव्ड मोस्ट ऑफ इट्स मैन्युफैक्चरिंग टू चाइना एंड को. कुछ इंडिया में थोड़ा बहुत बन जाता है, कुछ बांग्लादेश में बन जाता है कपड़े लत्ते, बाकी कोई भी चीज़ बनानी हो हमने चाइना में बनानी है. ठीक है. अब मसला ये है कि एक जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल पोलिश शू मैन्युफैक्चरर्स है ना, दे हैव लॉट्स ऑफ शू आउटलेट्स, CCC चेक. The problem they face is if they want the shoe to be delivered in autumn and get it manufactured in China, they have to place the order in January. Or autumn mein zyada thandi, autumn ka season pura clear nahi hua, unka maal nahi bikta. Because fashion is seasonal and cyclical. You need to have four seasons, clear seasons in Europe to get four rounds of sales of clothes. If there are no four clear seasons, तो ये लॉजिस्टिक सप्लाई चेन के मसले भी बहुत होते हैं. समटाइम्स दे हैव वर्किंग कैपिटल बलून्स एंड दे हैव टू गो आउट एंड बोरो मनी लाइक नो टुमारो एट प्राइसेस व्हिच डजंट मेक सेंस एंड मोस्ट ऑफ देयर मार्जिन्स आर डिस्ट्रॉयड इन पेइंग फॉर दैट इंटरेस्ट. दैट्स वेयर द प्रॉब्लम कम्स. अच्छा ये इसके बाद मैं छोड़ दूंगा क्योंकि आखिरी वाला फिश इन द बोल इज अ बिट हैवी आई गेस. लगता है सबको नींद भी आ रही है. अच्छा वो आयशा बीबी ने मुझसे कहा था कि व्हाई डोंट यू डू सम रिसर्च ऑन द वॉटर इशू. नो शी डजंट साउंड लाइक दैट, शी साउंड्स वेरी अथॉरिटेटिव वेरी. दोस्त है, बहुत अच्छी दोस्त है. और फरीद साहब ने कहा था हाँ दिस विल पीक योर इंटरेस्ट, दिस विल गिव यू इनफ डेटा, देयर इज इनफ डेटा फॉर यू टू यूज योर मेंटल एक्सरसाइज एंड यू विल एंजॉय दिस. Farid Fazal Panjwani is also a classmate of ours who is the head of the Department of Religious Studies in University College London. So he is uska dimag,
and he's a PhD from Oxford.
Oxford se usne religious studies mein PhD ki hai. Uska matlab hai ki duniya mein jitni kitabe religion ke upar hongi na wo sab padhi hai usne. Oxford mein PhD karna jo hai na, it's not a walk in the park, I kid you not. तो उन्होंने कहा कि कलीम साहब आप ही करके देखें. आई डोंट नो मच, सो नाउ थिंक लिसन टू व्हाट आई नो ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ व्हिच आई थिंक आई डोंट नो. ठीक है, ये आप पढ़ लें. आपने ये तो सुना होगा बहुत के 2/3 ऑफ द अर्थ इज कवर्ड विद वॉटर, 1/3 इज लैंड. हाउ मच ऑफ द वॉटर इज एक्चुअली सेलाइन? 97.5% ऑफ द वॉटर दैट वी नो ऑफ ऑन दिस अर्थ इज सेलाइन. यानी कि हमारे कंजम्पशन के लिए वो थोड़ा मुश्किल है. ठीक है, नमकीन पानी है यार. फ्रेश वॉटर फिर है 2.5%. Of that 2.5%, only less than 1% is above ground. So 1% of 2.5% is above ground. ठीक है, और जो यूजेबल पानी है उसमें कितना पानी जो 1% अबव, 1% ऑफ 2.5% विच इज अबव ग्राउंड, 0.0025% ऑफ ऑल द वॉटर इन द वर्ल्ड which is above ground, only 20% of that is accessible to human. Baki permafrost mein, Antarctic mein hai, Arctic mein hai, so accessible nahi. Uski ab udhar nahi jao, phir uske kahani mere ko aur lambi karni padegi yaar. I know what the cause and effect on that side as well.
Ji.
No, we are not consuming.
Like most of the companies there have a desalination plant and they're using the drinking water from the sea and they
So, like, are they in with the company? Is actually trapped, you know, extracting fresh water along the
ground? Like, yeah, this is aapka jo Indus River hai, wo fresh water hi to hai. Lake Geneva bhi to fresh water hi hai. The amount of water that Nestle or the whole, all the desalination plants that can possibly do in the whole world as it stands today is less than 1% of what is existence. Sab mila lo na, jitna bhi, wo 1% of abhi existing consumption pe hai, usse bhi kam hai. बता रहा हूँ ना वो जो मुझे मालूम है जो मुझे नहीं मालूम लेट मी गो थ्रू दैट सो व्हाट वी नो इज दिस सो अब देखते हैं क्या इश्यूज क्या आते हैं द इश्यूज दैट कम इनटू माइंड तो पहली तो आपने बात की कि सेलाइन वाटर को नॉन सेलाइन क्यों नहीं कर देते या बट द अमाउंट द एक्सटेंट टू विच दे आर डूइंग दैट इज नॉट इवन मेजरेबल द अमाउंट द साइज ऑफ द मार्केट दे आर सर्विंग इज अनमेजरेबल यार It's not measurable. It's not measurable. I promise you, it's not measurable.
But what do you think? Most of the world population is consuming freshwater.
Yes.
Yeah, of course.
99.9999997% of the world is consuming freshwater. And human consumption is a very small part of consumption of freshwater. PB, 1 kilo ki chicken khate ho na? The amount of water which goes through to create 1 kilo of chicken is 2,100 liters. The amount of water which goes through the rivers and going through all the process of going through wheat, feed growth, and cleaning and all that is 2,100 liters of water is spent to create 1 kilo weight of chicken meat. For beef, it is 21,000 liters. Hamna, aap kya pani peete ho yaar? आप जो बोल रहे हो कंजम्पशन का ये नेस्ले बना रही है गाय को थोड़ी खिला रहे हैं यार वो आई मीन द अमाउंट ऑफ वाटर यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट इज नथिंग एब्सोल्युटली नथिंग सो गोइंग बैक तो सेलिनिटी का एक फंक्शन है सी की सेलिनिटी का फंक्शन है यू नो सेलाइन वाटर वॉर्म्स अप स्लोअर देन फ्रेश वाटर राइट द टेम्परेचर लेवल इज डिफरेंट सो इफ यू जो आर्टिक का बोलते हैं मेल्टिंग आइस मेल्टिंग की कहानी करते हैं एंटार्क्टिक का और ये वेदर की वजह से हो रहा है देयर इज ओजोन लेयर इज बीन डिप्लीटेड एंड दिस आर्टिक वाटर एंड ब्ला 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 इज मेल्टिंग व्हाट डिफरेंस डज इट मेक व्हाट इट्स डूइंग इज इट्स रिड्यूसिंग द सेलिनिटी ऑफ वाटर इन दैट एरिया सो इफ इट रिड्यूसेस द सेलिनिटी ऑफ द वाटर इन दैट एरिया इट चेंजेस द वे द करंट्स इन द ओशंस दैट फ्लो ठीक है ना अगर 30% ऑफ द आर्टिक मेल्ट हो जाएगा ना पीबी तो फ्रॉम नॉर्थ स्कैंडिनेविया ऑल द वे डाउन टू स्पेन विल फ्रीज द सी विल फ्रीज क्योंकि द वाटर विच कीप्स द वाटर इंग्लिश चैनल और ये वार्म करके पानी को लिक्विड रखता है ना वो है द गल्फ स्ट्रीम विच कम्स फ्रॉम द मिडल बेल्ट ट्रॉपिकल बेल्ट से जो सी जाती है जब सेलिनिटी चेंज करते हो पानी की तो पानी के करंट की मोशन और डायरेक्शन को चेंज करते हो तो आपने कह दिया कि चलो भाई सेलाइन वाटर को हम इस्तेमाल करना शुरू कर दें पूरी दुनिया में तो वेदर का रफड़ा पड़ जाएगा सो यू विल क्रिएट अनदर प्रॉब्लम द पॉइंट आई एम ट्राइंग टू मेक इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट व्हेन पीपल स्टार्टेड टू यूज हाइड्रोकार्बन्स कि यार मजदूर हाथ से या गाय बैल से खेती बाड़ी नहीं करेंगे हम ट्रैक्टर चलाएंगे ठीक है So there was a huge benefit, industrial revolution. Food became cheaper, the amount of food available became more, and Malthusian limits, KRB will run out of food, were blown away. वो benefit तो हमको नजर आ गया उसके 100 साल बाद नुकसान क्या होता है वो अब हम भुगत रहे हैं due to environmental changes and weather changes. So when you look at wind farms, for example, wind farm पता ना क्या होता है क्यों ना वो पंखा चल रहा होता है बिजली बनती है तो when the wind blows through, It transfers some of its energy into the. So what happens to the wind which leaves that wind, pankha? Does it have the same amount of energy or less? Law of conservation of energy would say it has less amount of energy. तो उसका consequence क्या होगा भाई? किसी ने उसपे कहानी नहीं की, किसी ने study नहीं की उसके ऊपर. I promise you the consequences will be similar to what happened with the cold bloody thing. Same with solar panel. Sunlight reflect karti hai zameen ke upar, the heat gets absorbed in the earth. Solar panel lagate ho, so you don't allow that heat to be absorbed in the earth. You convert that into electricity. That heat kahin zameen pe ja rahi hai, uska kuch function hai. We don't know, we haven't studied enough of the function. Theek hai? So that is a problem which we don't understand today. The water jo hai masla ye nahi hai kitna hai kitna kam ho raha hai. We have about 11,500 liters per head. Sorry, 1,500 meters per head of water in the world, cubic meters per head in the water. Masla ye hai ki jahan chahiye wahan nahi hai, jahan nahi chahiye wahan pe zyada hai. Aur hum iska istemal sahi nahi karte. So if we address the logistics and storage problem of water, it will be much better solution than desalination, I think. Because what you're trying to do is you're not disturbing or stopping the water coming in or coming out. What you're trying to do is you're trying to limit the wastage of water. You're trying to make better use of water. Jin log jo gharon mein rehte hain, unke paas jo gardens hote hain, usme wo pani dalte hain na, fresh water. Kyun bhai? Keeda? जो तुमने हाथ धोया साबुन से, उस पानी को आप फिल्टर करके उसको इस्तेमाल क्यों नहीं कर लेते? वो घास को थोड़ी पता है उसमें क्या डाला है आपने, यार हाथ धुला हुआ है कि नहीं धुला हुआ. व्हाट डिफरेंस डज इट मेक? इट डजंट मेक एनी डैम डिफरेंस टू द गार्डन. बट यू डोंट डू इट, यू डोंट इवन नो दैट यू आर वेस्टिंग वाटर. दावतों में जाते हैं आप, देखते हैं कितनी मुर्गियां और टेबलों पर छोड़ी हुई जाती हैं या खाना ज़ाया होता है, तो बोलती है पैसे ज़ाया कर दिए, पैसे ज़ाया कर दिए, खाना ज़ाया हो गया, लोगों को तमीज़ नहीं है, भूखों को देना चाहिए, दिस दैट एंड द अदर. Do you have any bloody idea how much water you are wasting? Yeah. Any tipping clue what water you are wasting? No, you don't. So my answer was that, "Bhai, I have this solution. I don't know how can you, on a regional or global scale, resolve the storage and logistic issues of water." Okay. एक तो मेरे पास ये जवाब नहीं था. दूसरा सवाल ये था कि यार कंजम्पशन एफिशिएंसी कैसे लाई जाए. आई हैव नो आइडिया हाउ टू कम अबाउट विद द कंजम्पशन एफिशिएंसी टू और द लॉजिस्टिक्स ऑफ वाटर और स्टोरेज ऑफ वाटर. जब इन तीनों चीज़ों का जवाब मेरे पास नहीं हो सकता, मैं इस बारे में लिख के करूँगा क्या? बाकी सारी चीज़ें तो मुझे मालूम है, वो सबको मालूम होनी चाहिए. वो क्यों नहीं है उसका मेरे पास जवाब नहीं है. ठीक है, चाहे बुद्धू हों या अकल का काम है या इस्तेमाल नहीं करते दिमाग को जो उनके पास है, आई डोंट नो. Or they don't care enough about it, I don't know. What I do know is what I know is easily knowable.
Okay, so Cape Town is running out of water.
Ah.
The world's first city.
Which ran out of water?
To actually be dry, they don't have a drop of water.
Ah. So, ye.
Now, I'm searching if this thing will come to you.
Ye aapke upar aana hai. पाकिस्तान का है एवरेज अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ वाटर पर हेड इज 945 क्यूबिक मीटर्स पर हेड, राइट? इंडिया में 1430 क्यूबिक मीटर पर हेड है. ये छोटी छोटी चीज़ तो मुझे पता है, मुझे ज़्यादा नहीं मालूम. तो ये हाउ डिड आई कम अबाउट विद दिस स्मॉल थिंग विच आई डोंट नो अबाउट? आई यूज्ड एनवायरमेंटल स्टडीज एंड साइंसेस. वेदर पैटर्न्स कैसे चेंज होता है, एनवायरमेंट कैसे चेंज होता है, वो कहाँ होता है, उसका थोड़ा बहुत मुझे मालूम है. ओजोन लेयर कैसे बनती है, कहाँ बनती है, व्हाट इज द वर्स्ट ग्रीन हाउस गैस दैट वी हैव दैट वी कांट डू अ डैम थिंग अबाउट, क्या है अंदाजा कुछ? ग्रीन हाउस गैसेस को तो आप क्या बोलते हो? CO2 बोलते हो ना, उसके अलावा कुछ है? विच इज द बिगेस्ट कंट्रीब्यूटर ऑफ ग्रीन हाउस गैस इफेक्ट? विच इज द बिगेस्ट कंट्रीब्यूटर ऑफ ग्रीन हाउस गैस इफेक्ट? है सॉरी नहीं कम हो कम हो नहीं पानी वाटर वेपर समंदर से जो पानी उड़ता है वो बादल बनते हैं ना. 50% ऑफ ग्रीन हाउस गैस इफेक्ट इज कॉज्ड बाय वाटर वेपर. क्या करोगे? बादल नहीं चाहिए, पानी नहीं चाहिए, उसका तो कुछ भी नहीं कर सकते आप. 50% दैट पूरी, यार आपका मुल्क, आपकी दुनिया स्कैंडिनेविया की दुनिया से अलग नहीं है. सबको अफेक्ट पड़ता है, कुछ को कम लग रहा है अभी, कुछ को ज्यादा लग रहा है. देयर विल बी टाइम एवरीबॉडी विल बी अफेक्टेड मैसिवली. It's a matter of time.
शायद
आपको आपकी प्रोजेनी खत्म करनी हो, that's a different story. तो आपके बच्चों के लिए आप जिंदगी बुरी करना चाहते हो, कमाल हैं आप यार. You are one of the best. I mean, that's yes. Yeah, so you want to leave a world for your children and their grandchildren.
Exactly the thought process of every saint in Pakistan right now.
दिमाग नहीं है बोलता, पगार बढ़ाओ.
हम तो बन जाएंगे ना भाड़ में.
औलाद मरे उसका कोई मसला नहीं है ना.
चलो
ओके, सो लेट मी कम बैक. So I employed environmental studies and knowledge of that. I looked at green lobbies manifestos, जो green lobbies होती हैं, parties, political parties. I looked at the laws of thermodynamics, obviously, geosciences, anthology of societies, how societies move and how it works, where they are formed, what is the basis of that. हाइड्रोकार्बन डिस्कवरीज एंड डेवलपमेंट, किस तरह से मालूम किया था, कहाँ से ढूंढा है, व्हाट आर द टेक्नोलॉजीज यूज. और जो अमेरिका शोर मचाता है कि वी हैव व्हाट डू दे कॉल इट शेल ऑयल, जिसकी वजह से वो शोर मचा रहा है. एवरी लीटर ऑफ शेल ऑयल, एवरी गैलन ऑफ शेल ऑयल दैट कम्स आउट रिक्वायर 17 टाइम्स मोर वाटर देन नॉर्मल वाटर, नॉर्मल गैलन. तो वो अपना ही बजा रहा है, बेफिक्र रहो. हाइड्रोसाइंसेज ऑब्वियसली बायोलॉजी, and finally business and economics. In sare discipline ko cross karta hu to ye mujhe samajh aati hai, which is not enough for me to address the problem clearly enough for me to write something on. For me, I don't know about anybody else, for me it's not good enough. Ye mera favorite hai yaar. Consider a lily pond with goldfish living in the pond. For the fish swimming freely in the water, which would appear clear and immaterial. Pani to machli ko nazar nahi aata na, it's clear, right? Well, it is like air. Air is clear and immaterial to us. Same is for the fish. Yeah. The whole world for the fish revolves around swimming in it. Uske liye sari duniya jo hai, uski kainat jo hai, wo fish pond hai. वो फिश पॉन्ड है जहां पर है. बाहर पानी है या नहीं उसको मालूम ही नहीं, उसको तो यही मालूम है कि यही मेरी कायनात है, उसके अलावा ही डजंट नॉट एबल टू सी और नो. वो क्या करती है, वो खाने की खाती है, पीती है, मौज करती है, बच्चे पैदा करती है, व्हाटएवर. उसकी जिंदगी उसी पे पॉन्ड में एग्जिस्ट करती है. उसके जहन में कभी आता ही नहीं है कि इस पॉन्ड से बाहर गुजरे, कि वो सवाल जो है वो सवाल गलत है, तो होता ही नहीं है. So everything that the fish knows, all the dimension, all the thought process is limited to that of the pond. अब होता ये है कि कभी फिश पानी में स्विम करके जा रही है, बहुत जोर से करंट आ गया, ठीक है. वो करंट क्यों आया, जो लिली ऊपर तैर रहा था ना, वो दैट मूव्ड, ऊपर हवा चल रही थी, लिली मूव्ड, लिली के रूट्स ने पानी को हिला दिया. तो उसने पता है क्या किया, उसने कहा अल्लाह ताला की वजह से ये हुआ है, अल्लाह ताला ने बारिश की है या ये किया है या वो किया है, व्हाटएवर. और पानी पे जो पॉन्ड है उस पर बारिश हो रही है, बारिश होती है, पानी लगता है तो रिबल्स क्रिएट होते हैं, उसकी वजह से नीचे ग्रेविटेशन होती है. ओहो, ये तो हमारे ऊपर कयामत आ गई है, ये तो हमारे घरों को तबाह कर दिया जाएगा, ये कौन कर रहा है, ये कौन सा मनुष्य. दैट्स हाउ दे थिंक. अब इन मछलियों में से एक मछली को आप थोड़ी देर के लिए बाहर निकाल दो, तो दैट फिश जंप्स आउट ऑफ द वॉटर and then sees कि यार ये जो सैलाब आ रहा था, ये दलबली मच रही थी, ये तो पॉन्ड में लिली हिल रही है. नथिंग मोर देन जस्ट अ मूवमेंट ऑफ दैट कम्स एंड देन ही सीज कि यार बारिश होती है तो रिपल बनते हैं, उसकी वजह से नीचे आता. उस मछली को 15 सेकंड बाहर रही, ये समझ आ गई, देन इट गोज बैक इनटू द वॉटर. आप मुझे बताओ कि उसकी जिंदगी का क्या हाल हुआ होगा. वो अपनी सहेलियों से मिल रही है, दोस्तों से मिल रही है, बात कर रही. नहीं नहीं, ये कोई और नहीं कर रहा, ये तो हवा चल रही है बाहर. बोलते क्या बात कर रहे हो यार, बाहर क्या होती है हवा, कैसी बेकार बात कर रहे हो, इसके बाहर तो कुछ होता ही नहीं. नहीं नहीं, मैंने देखा है, हो ही नहीं सकता, अगर तुम पानी से बाहर निकलोगे तो तुम मर जाओगी, ये कैसे हो सकता है. दैट इज द प्रॉब्लम व्हेन यू लुक एट थिंग फ्रॉम ओनली वन सीरीज ऑफ पर्सपेक्टिव, वन सेट ऑफ डायमेंशंस. You step yourself out of that dimension, you are able to see reality more clearly and the truth more clearly. So don't look at things in only one way and the same way possible. You have to come out and think different. If you want to make sure that you survive in the new world, new century, you have to think different. You have to have imagination and creativity to create your place in this world. Otherwise, you will be the same lawyer or the same doctor. Saab, hame naukri de do, saab. Saab, main achha kaam karta hun, saab. That's the fourth fodder you will become. Unless you are able to think creatively and use your imagination and go beyond what you have learned in the books. Achha, aakhri cheez jo hai na, hamare ek dost hai, uski kuch kahawate hai shayad. Hai ki nahi hai? Children who are not taught to think for themselves, when they become adults, have nothing of their own. All they are is a reflection of what somebody else told them. They have nothing of their own. There is no such thing as truly objective fact or phenomena, even in the physical world. What is considered objective fact or phenomena is nothing more than observational symmetry. The higher the level of observational symmetry, the more real and objective that fact or phenomena is considered. Nahi samajh aayi? Acha. Choti si baat hai. Hum kya kehte hain angrezi mein? Sun rises in the east and sets in the west. Everybody says this. Right? Oh, keda sunrise hota hai? Sun ne to udhar hi rehna hai. Aur duniya ghoom rahi hai. Because everybody says sun rises in the east and sets in the west, that has become your objective reality. It's not true at all. Sun doesn't do a damn thing. Yeah, it stays where it is. No, it's actually moving at 146,000 miles a second across the Milky Way. That's a different story. Wo aur kahani hai, wo kisi aur zamane ki baat hai. So, aakhri cheez jo hai, never accede to stated authority, but always to reason. Main keh raha hu, isliye karo. Nahi. Reason. Reason. As reason is the ultimate authority which prevails after all. So reason hai, wohi hoga. Bas ji. That's all I have. Aap kisi ko kuch sawal karna hai ya ghar jana hai, mujhe bata de. And the last thing, sorry, before I forget. This is one view. You have to come up with your own. Thank you very much.